Many controller players can agree that aim assist is insanely overrated in Season 7, and aiming on controller is harder than it's ever been. A lot of controller players have been having trouble aiming recently, and this is the perfect video if you're one of them, alright? So aiming is the biggest factor that plays into winning your fights in Fortnite, and is why you need to focus on having the best aim possible. If you have trouble aiming, man, you're basically throwing away your mechanical skill, as aim is what wins you fights. What's going on, guys? This is your motivation guy. That's right, Keith Allen, the captain of the Bunch of Crunch Army, and today, we're gonna be showing you guys the best tips and tricks to improve your aim on the sticks. Let me ask you this question. What input curve do you guys play on? Is it linear or exponential? Let me know in the comments down below. We're definitely gonna check it out. You know, a huge flaw every player notices when playing controller is where they place their crosshair and how they utilize it in a fight. Many players have trouble flicking and constantly hitting their shotgun shots. You know, they may think that aim assist will do all the work for them, but that is definitely not the case. And so pro controller player Day even stated that even if you're on a controller, your aim won't be as good as without practicing crosshair placement. And so there is a reason Day has the best shotgun aim in the game, and it's just because of the time he takes to mastering crosshair placement. And so having good crosshair placement may seem easy with aim assist and tracking your opponent, but that actually makes it even harder when you're just trying to get a big pump with just your joysticks. So take it from me personally, man, precise aiming on controller is definitely hard. Many players make the mistake of L2 spamming or flicking their joysticks around too much. And so to avoid making the mistake of overshooting and flicking too much, try your best to keep your crosshair steady and track your opponent's head to your best ability. You know, whenever you move around, always adjust your crosshair slightly and follow your opponent, rather than having to readjust your aim after repositioning yourself. For example, having your shotgun out and running around your opponent's builds while tracking them is a great way of improving your crosshair placement. Never take your sight off the target, all right? Also, crosshair placement also has a lot to do with building and editing, and is why that you need to put in that practice to become accurate. You know, the biggest factor to having the best aim is practicing consistently. Nobody can come out of nowhere and just suddenly be the best, and you need to put in that work to really get there. You know, every pro player grinds for more than 6 hours a day, and training their aim and mechanics before scrimming is just a huge part of their daily routine. So practicing is something every player does by just playing the game, but being efficient while doing so. And that really separates a pro from an average player. The best way to practice your controller aim is actually playing creative maps such as Scovax, you know, Aim Trainer, and Raider 464 Aim Duels. I say this all the time on my Instagram at Your Motivation Guy. Come check me out. You know, these maps are the controller version of Kovacs. Definitely just help you much better with your play consistently. And not only are these maps very enjoyable, they're also there to help you guys improve, like your aim by tenfold. Start off in creative by using aim training maps, you know, preferably the Scovax Aim Trainer V6. Scovax is the best aim training map in Fortnite and will help you easily improve every aspect of your aim. Make sure you run each scenario a couple of times and do that for 30 minutes a day. And this is gonna help you realize your strengths and weaknesses and what you need to do to really practice the most. And so admitting your mistakes is so important for success, guys. Make sure that you look back and see what you can do to get better. This map will definitely help you guys a ton with tracking and flicking, two things that are very hard to master on controller. You know, you can also change what range that you're shooting from and practice long range aim, man. Controller players struggle the most with long range aim, and is why this map is perfect to really practice with. Another great aim training map out there is Raider 464 Aim Duels. Here we go. The Raider 464 Aim Duel map is definitely going to allow you to choose from a variety of different scenarios and allows you to customize your health and weapons and fighting space. So queue up with a friend, 1v1 them a couple times. You know, this Aim Duels map will help you warm up very quickly and make sure that your tracking and crosshair placements is to your best potential. You should spend at least 20 minutes a day on this map, and it really helps you out. You know, almost every single pro player uses this map and have permanently implemented this map into their routines. You know, you can also queue into the map and go into the matchmaking if you need someone to play with. All right, when it comes to getting better at Fortnite, man, there is a world of information out there, but not everything always gives you structure. And so if you want pro one-on-one coaching from the top pros, go to proguys.com and sign up today using code RANKUP2021 for 20% off. They are designed to train you in every area, and according to your pace, we highly recommend it. Okay, so now that we've talked about sensitivity, let's do a little more in depth on which input curve will help you guys abuse your aim assist to the maximum. You need to switch to linear mode if you haven't already, as it's just much easier to aim up close, especially when using spray weapons. Linear is definitely something every controller player should be using, unless you're finding some game-changing results on exponential. Of course, the linear input curve is worse in the long-range game, but the change is barely noticeable. You know, exponential mode is just definitely worse for close-range fights, and is not as powerful as a controller player on linear. The aim assist is a little bit weaker and exponential requires you to play much slower. Exponential is better for defensive players and players who get their surge tags with rifles rather than taking early game fights. Exponential will also be worse for your crosshair placement as it's just much harder to really be smooth on it, right? You know, linear helps you stay smooth and it's just easier to make precise movements on it. Exponential mode is just much better for long range tracking and will help you hit more long range shots. However, this will barely affect you and is why linear mode is better. You know, many players make the mistake of aiming for the body and letting aim assist track for them, you know, without making any fine adjustments. And so to avoid making these mistakes, you need to make sure that your sensitivity, your dead zones, and overall feel of your controller is perfect for you. You know, everybody plays the game differently, but make sure that your sensitivity isn't too high and change your dead zones to 10 for both joysticks if you haven't already. You can also invest into controller add-ons such as Control Freaks if you think your joystick control would be better. This will help you hit shots more consistently and help you aim with any gun imaginable. And so the last tip that we have to be more comfortable aiming is adjusting how close your monitor is. You know, if you feel your monitor is too small or too far away, do everything possible to fix it. Professional players can agree that the closer your monitor is, the better it is for your crosshair placement. CSGO is a game that requires the best crosshair placement possible, and it's why many of their pro players literally have their monitors in their face. So to be specific, make sure your look sensitivities are both around 40% range. You know, playing on the default settings is not a good idea, and you've most likely switched off of them. So, you know, but if you haven't, make sure you do this as soon as possible. All right. Having a good sensitivity is a very important thing to have this season, especially with the pump shotgun. The pump rewards very good aimers and really shows why crosshair placement is so important in Fortnite. Always use a medium sensitivity in which you can easily maneuver around and be accurate with your shots. Make sure to check out our previous controller settings video if you're ever having trouble finding the perfect sensitivity, all right? Bloom and recoil is something that many controller players overlook just because they think aim assist will perfectly guide their shots to hitting their opponent 100% of the time. This is absolutely not the case, and controlling your bloom and recoil is actually much harder than you think. So to control your bloom on controller, you need to utilize tap firing and ADSing in fast motion. This obviously doesn't mean that you should just spam your ADS button, you know, L2 spamming, but you know, you should use it to readjust your bloom. The best way to control bloom easier is by tap firing at long ranges and readjusting your crosshair whenever you start missing a lot of shots. And so in addition, you know, make sure to spam crowd as it actually helps with bloom, especially at medium ranges with an AR. So next time you have bad bloom, just stop spraying and reposition yourself before you spray again. By just changing up how you shoot, guys, your AR aim was gonna be much more better. Along with hitting more shots, it can also catch your opponents off guard. All right, here we go. You know, we want your aim to be the best it could be, so let's just do a recap of everything we talked about real quick. So to make sure your crosshair placement is optimal, you need to practice. Utilize all of our tips in this section to be at your maximum potential when playing. And remember to keep your crosshair steady. Always track your opponent when you are in an up-close fight and try your best to stay calm when aiming up close. All right, so to recap, make sure to use the Skavach Aim Trainer and Raider 464's aim duels to your advantage. Spend around 25 minutes on each map and make sure that you stay consistent. But overall, you know, we really recommend that you switch to linear as most of your fights will definitely be easier on it. Just use the Skavach Aim Trainer to practice your long range aim and linear aim assist will take care of close range for you guys. All right, so to recap this section, make sure that you are comfortable with your setup and practice your new sensitivities in the creative maps that we previously mentioned. Never play in ways that limit your gameplay. Remember that. All right, so make sure that you use your time, you know, when you, you know, just make sure that you take your time when spraying your enemies on controller and you're easily gonna start hitting more shots. And so this section has a lot to do with how you shoot rather than how accurate your aim is. So make sure to practice this as much as you can. We really hope you guys enjoyed this video and learned something new today. And you know, having good aim on controller is very important to becoming a good player. And using our tips and tricks will easily get you there. Make sure to practice with these new settings and stay calm and have steady crosshair placement. Utilize our creative maps to stay on top of your game. Hey, once again, this is your motivation guy, Keith Allen, the captain of the Bunch of Crunch Army. Make sure to connect with me on my Instagram at yourmotivationguy. If you guys liked the video, make sure you subscribe to the channel. We have so much more great content coming out. I promise you this. I'll see you on the next one. Peace.